What does it mean? Has include str.h. That means this particular file. This is called the library file. Actually, when we are in this semester, what will happen? Then there is a different subject which is not known to you. So that's why you keep several books from the library. And whenever something is actually you are not doing, you are not familiar with it, you go to the library, take the book, and then do the same. This is happening the same thing. What does it mean? This one is the preprocessor directory. This has function is known as preprocessor directory. What we have to do? We have to include this particular library file in our program by using this preprocessor directory. This is the meaning of that. This is the meaning of that. Thus, we are including this particular library file in our program by using this preprocessor directory. Okay. Now, what we need? You have to, you write something else like integer main. If we want to take like that two elements and we have to add something, so we have to take some variables and you are saying that you have to enter two numbers and by using scanf and then so this is a simple program which takes two numbers and add it and then display the result. So please, what is the meaning of this one? Yeah?
Name is a function.
Name is a function. And this one is?
Return type.
Okay, why we write this integer? If we write void or if we don't write anything, it will also work. Okay, in several books, in Kanishka or everyone, you don't see that they will give integer. They will give void. Okay, void is a primary data type, that's why. So, why we give integer? It is better to use integer or it is better to use void?
Void.
Why?
By default value.
By default value. Actually, the thing is, it is better to write integer because the default return type of the main function is integer. So, always try to write integer and give the return 0. Okay. If you can write float, it also works, but you have to write 0.0. Okay. So, the default return type of main is integer. So, it is always better to write integer rather than void. Okay. Now, these are called something variables. That means when you are write A, B, C, so there is a memory block where A, B and some. It has some address also. It is already been there. This is called variable. Why it is called variable? Because you can change the name. It is not right that you have to write on the AB. You can name it as a, your name or something else. Now we have to give the two numbers. Just remember, because in previously the scanf, where we have to use scanf, this is the main problem. When I'm entering some data through keyboard, then you have to use scanf. When you are using string or something else, then you have to use get output, that is a rather different section. But the thing is, now you just know that when you have to enter something through keyboard, you have to use scanf. By using scanf, you are using integer variable, you are declaring integer variable, that's why you are writing %d%. If you are using float variable, then you have to write %f. Or if you double or something else, you have to write this notation corresponding to this data type. And this ampersand A, ampersand B, this is the address. So, A is a variable which has in a memory block, wherever A is created, it has some address. We have to store the value which is inserted through the keyboard. It should be stored at A, say 5, you have to insert through the keyboard that you inserted 5. Then it should be stored at the location A and say 5 in B. So, by using this, A plus B, that means it should be same. Now you have to print something and we are writing it %d, that means this particular value of the sum will be replaced by this. Okay, clear? Now run another program. It is the similar thing. We are just writing. What is the output of this program?
A.
Yeah?
A.
A. Run kar do. Run it. This is a simple program. Integer main float x equals to 0.7. You are checking with x 0.7. If it is true, then it will print A. Otherwise, it print B. Right? No? Simple. And your answer is, it will of course print A. Run for it.